Hello all, welcome to Pantech e-learning. Today we are going to see how to run the code of intrusion detection. Okay, so generally what is introduction? Intrusion detection is nothing but like when we are doing some transaction and when we are doing some data transferring from one computer to another computer, we will be get some interrupt or we will be get some attack. Otherwise, generally it will be shared from one source to destination. It will occur some problems. Okay, so for that purpose, we are using this. We are going to see how the intrusion detection is working. For that purpose, you need to install the Anaconda Navigator and open the Jupyter Notebook. Then it will be open in your browser. So here we have a project code and then intrusion detection. I'm opening this intrusion detection. Before that, you need to know about data set. So the data set we downloaded from the official website of KDD Cup 19 AM. So this is the link. So using this link only we are going to download the data set. And regarding data set description also I shared in our code itself. We will check it out within this Jupyter Notebook. So here we imported some basic packages and after this we are reading the data set, and after that we are checking whether the data set read properly or not, and then we are checking the columns, and then we are checking the information, and after this we are going to check the shape of the and then null values. Okay, so if it is a null values, it machine learning algorithm won't train, so we are checking the null values. Then we are going to convert our some object type. Here you can see we have an object type. So if you open this data set, you will be have a information regarding some details about transaction. Okay, so just wait a minute, it's loading. Why? Because it's a large data set, so it's still loading. Generally, if you take a data set columns or rows, you will be have nearly 494,021. Here we are having duration, protocol, service, flag, this and our network oriented, right? So, and then this is actually here you can see like protocol type TCP, UDP, like this. We are having some information details. And here you can see label, it's in a categorical column value, so we need to convert this categorical column value into a numerical column. So for that purpose only we are using these steps. So here we are converting our data, here we are checking how many categories are available in protocol type, that is in object type. Here where we are having an object, here we are having object, and here we are having object, here we are having object. So if you are getting object data type, you need to convert into an integer type. That is, we need to do some labeled encoding. So for that purpose only we are going to check here how many categories are available in protocol and how many categories are available in services, flag and label. Okay, so after this we are doing pre-processing. So pre-processing label encoder, converting your object type into an integer type. Okay, so for that purpose we are using, so here I am applying the label encoder type all the columns. Then after applying, if I check the data set, we will be have only all the column will be in the form of integer. Okay, so then we are checking the information again. We are having a last label column only object. Apart from this, everything in integer and float type. So why we are leaving this object label column means, here in label column we are having different categories. Okay, nearly we already checked, right? So here you can see we are having different categories. Totally we have 23 categories. Okay, different type of unique categories are there. Totally 23 unique categories are there. So here I am going to concatenate all these 23 unique category into three classes. One is normal, another one is DDoS attack, and another one is PROB. So what is this PROB? I already given an output. Okay, DOS is nothing but denial of service, DDoS attack, generally we call us, and then probe R2L and U2R. This and all here I have explained what is this R2L and what is this U2R. Let's read it. Then we are going to summarize as a three categories. One is normal, another one is DDoS, another one is probe. Okay. So again, I am giving all the data. Then it will be converted. After converted, we are label column also will be converted into an integer column. Okay. Then again, if I check the data here, integer type. Okay. So the next thing I'm going to see whether how the classification parts are there. Okay, 0, 1 and 2. Okay, then we are going to do feature selection. Here I'm taking an all the data, that is independent data and dependent data. Okay. And after that I'm training the model. Then we are finding the features, important features of my model. That is by using extra tree classifier. So we are having another one, best feature selection classifier algorithm, like CGH2 and the select best. So even though we are applying these two, and we are going to predict the score value. So this is the score value of after applying the this one, CGH2 and select best. Okay. So if I run this part, definitely I will be get a it takes some time, so I didn't run this, just to see this. Then we are going to train the algorithm. So we are going to divide our data into two types, train and test fitting. After that, importing a random forest algorithm. Then we are training the random forest algorithm. Then we are checking the accuracy score, and then we are checking the classification report. Then after that, importing an SVM algorithm. Then we are checking the accuracy score of SVM algorithm and classification report. Then we are going to plot a graph for final result value of how it's performing random forest and support vector machine. Okay, so this is the code. Check it out. Thank you for watching.